So in this test, we're going to examine for the presence of proteins. So to do that, we're going to use two reagents. We have copper sulfate and sodium hydroxide. So when these two are added together, they will react to form a blue precipitate if there's no proteins. However, if proteins are present, the copper 2 plus from the copper sulfate will be able to directly interact with the amino groups of proteins, and that's going to change the solution to a purple, kind of purple pink color. So the presence of proteins, it's specifically looking at the presence of peptide bonds, is going to be detected by the reaction with the copper 2 plus. And so we're going to be able to examine the extent of peptide bonds or the amount of proteins within our sample based on the deepening of that color. So the darker that color, the more proteins, the more peptide bonds are present in that sample. So what we're going to do is we're going to add the samples first this time. So we're going to add DI water for our negative control. So 10 drops. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And we are going to add albumin as our example protein. So you might have talked about albumin before in the process of denaturation. So albumin is a protein that's commonly used in a lot of different organisms, but you might have talked about the concept about how when you fry an egg, you permanently denature a protein within that, the egg white. What you're out denaturing is the protein albumin. So we're going to be examining using this protein. So we're going to add 10 drops of albumin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And we're going to mix up the solutions. And what we're going to do is we're going to add 20 drops of each of these reagents. So I'm going to add 20 drops of sodium hydroxide first. So this is a very strong base, a 1 molar solution. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. I'm going to mix that up a little bit. And I'm going to add this also to our positive control. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. I'm going to mix this up. And now we're going to add the copper sulfate. So if this reacts with proteins, you're going to see a purplish pink color, and if there's no proteins present, you should see a blue precipitate forming. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. You can already see that happening here. Wherever I mix this up, I'm going to continue to have that blue precipitate forming. And if I were to allow this to settle, that blue precipitate would settle on the bottom of my test tube. So we're going to let that sit for a second while we do the next one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So you already can see there's a difference here. You can see at the bottom, even before I shake it, there's a violet color. So if I were to continue to mix this, again, very carefully to not mix it where it's going to come out, you can see there's a really distinct color change happening where the test tube is now, the solution in the test tube is turning to be a violet color. So that violet color is indicative of a really large amount of protein. If it's a slight pink, it would maybe indicate more of a smaller concentration of proteins. So the gradation from pink to purple can help you differentiate the amount of proteins, the amount of peptide bonds in the solution. So again, very clear, distinct color change between the two. And you can see there are kind of flocculates. You can see the precipitate within that solution there, and you can see it's starting to kind of settle a little bit on the bottom. If we were to let this go for another hour, you would see that settling of all of the precipitate on the bottom of this test tube.